All right, with us for the first time here in the studio is Senator-elect Nancy Binay. Nancy, welcome to Hot Copy. All right,
morning.
So how are you feeling?
Okay.
Feeling,
so far.
Has it sunk in that you are now a senator?
A little bit.
Oh.
Siguro yung first day talagang doon na yung ano.
Oo.
Na I'm really a senator.
Now, do you feel vindicated at some point? I mean, may ganun ka bang pakiramdam? Because, let's face it, you were criticized, you were vilified. How do you feel now?
Ako, I didn't expect the ranking-wise I'll get yung top five. Na, because I think among all the candidates, ako ata yung pinaka na black propaganda among the senatorials, diba?
So what do you think did it, Nancy?
Because I think at the end of the day, it's still my last name. Yung the kind of service that my family gives, diba?
Mm-mm. So ito nga, forgive me for asking this, no, but a lot of the criticisms early on was you never attended the debates. Why didn't you attend the debates? Was that strategy?
Well, if you remember, among the senatorials, I was the last one who filed my candidacy, diba? Because I was just a last-minute replacement kay Joey De Venecia. So my campaign team decided na ang priority namin is the campaign sorties.
Mm-mm.
So if it's in conflict with the debate or TV guestings, ang priority ko is to attend the campaign sorties.
Kumbaga magpakilala,
yes,
groundwork.
Yes.
Did you do your father's campaign style?
Yes, talagang ano kami, kumbaga kung kayang one-on-one, kumbaga parang we did kung anong ginagawa sa local na house-to-house.
Yun ang ginawa mo?
Hindi naman house-to-house, pero talagang like in a day, we would start before sunrise nga eh, tapos after sunset, we're still on the road, doing our motorcades, doing our rallies.
But did you also think that debates could be bad for a candidate?
Siguro, depende, diba? Pero sa akin kasi nag-work yung ganong strategy na talagang face-to-face contact with the constituents. Kasi if you remember, I think some of the candidates, they already had intentions of running, diba? So, nag-iikot na yung iba sa kanila. Eh ako, wala akong ganong plan eh. So, sabi ko nga din sa campaign trail, most of the provinces that we visited, parang first time ko na pumunta.
Mm-mm. Okay, Nancy, how do you respond to criticisms that you have absolutely no work experience and now you are a senator? Actually, this was one of the, in fact nga, yun ang si Vice Ganda na, kumbaga, di ba, sinabi nga niya, parang hindi pa sapat ang kakayanan, nag-senador ka agad.
Ang hirap kasi sa akin, hindi nila alam yung trabaho ko is behind the scenes, di ba? So in terms of experience sa public service, this is nothing new to me. Sabi nga, I read in one interview kay Chris Aquino, she said na to prepare herself, parang she plans to do on-the-job training sa mga mayors, di ba? Eh ako, I've been doing this for what, more than 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that is experience enough. Kaso lang nga, hindi lang kasi nila alam yung ginagawa ko behind the scenes. So parang akala nila wala akong alam.
Tell me what you've learned from your father.
A lot. Una-una, dapat yung mga projects na dapat na gagawin namin, dapat nararamdaman ng kababayan natin. Kaya if you can see sa Makati, yung thrust palagi is result-oriented. So that's why we have yung mga senior citizens program, yung health program namin. Kasi kailangan na dadama nila yung, kumbaga, hindi dapat kasama sila sa pag-unlad. So ganun yung mindset na natutunan ko sa father ko.
Oo. So can you take this to the Senate? Eh, sa Senado, you have to make laws.
I think kasi siguro dapat yung laws that we will make is unang-una doable at talagang makakatulong din sa mga kababayan natin.
May mga nagsabi rin na I'll have to ask. Anyway, nanalo ka na naman eh, that you were your father's cake supplier. Is that true?
No, that's not true.
Okay,
sabi ko
I
am my father's eyes and ears on the ground.
Oo.
That's
You've heard
job.
About that, no? Kasi sa Makati, libre ang cake.
Yeah, sa senior citizen.
Sa senior citizen.
No, that's not true.
Yung mother-in-law ko, tuwan-tuwa dun sa libreng cake. Ang tanong ng marami is, hindi ba si Nancy Binay was the cake supplier?
No, I don't supply that. Unang-una, I don't cook and I don't bake. It's my husband who is in charge of the kitchen. So that's not my...
So it's not your company?
No.
It's not yours that supplies the cake in Makati.
Saka una-una, why would I do that? Bawal na mag-supply kami, di ba? Because my father's the mayor, my brother's the mayor. So, why would we do that?
But I've heard somebody say that the only political dynasty that has won across the board are the Binays. Your father, you, your sister. Did your sister run, Abby?
Yes.
And then your brother, which was a landslide victory.
So I'm the fourth.
You're the fourth. And then your mother was mayor once.
For one term. And I worked for her then.
Oo. Now, do you think dapat may hangganan ang pamilyang tumatakbo?
I guess for me, at the end of the day, decision ng mga constituents yun, di ba? If they want another Binay as part of government. And I think after winning this battle, gusto pa nila na may isa pang Binay sa ating pamahalaan.
Oo. Okay. Now, this is very interesting. Will you be, may nagtanong sa akin, can you ask her if she will be hiring UP Ateneo professors, lawyers in her staff?
Siyempre, una-una nga, like yung tinitignan ko ng chief of staff, UP graduate. Siyempre, love my own, ano, di ba? Alma mater, which is UP.
So, what was your course in UP?
Tourism. In fact, you know, I don't know if you remember, I used to see you before nung freshman ako because you were carpool mates with my friend.
Are you serious?
So, dun sa AS steps. And I think, naging classmate pa kita sa isang PE subject.
Totoo ba to? Parang lumagpak ako sa PE eh.
Parang we nutrition, parang ganun yung ano. It's a school type of PE subject hindi yung sports.
Oh my God, thank you for remembering. So you're much younger than me. I'm 42. You're 38.
I'm 40.
You turned 40?
Kasi yung friend ko lives in Merville. So carpool kayo.
Oh my God, tingnan mo naman po ang kasaysayan, no? Ngayon senador na po siya.
And you're the Karen Davila. But did you actually sa UP pa lang you're the Karen Davila already?
No, but did you think that ano, you would become senator? I heard, tell me if this is true. You asked your father to put you in and he didn't want in the beginning?
No, never did that. In fact,
how were you chosen sa family?
Nakakatawa nga eh. This is all destiny ba or calling? Because I really had no plans of entering politics. Alam ko, I think sabi ko, it will skip sa akin. So yun, ayoko sumali eh. Because I know it's difficult. I will lose my privacy, my anonymity. And that was very important to me, diba? In spite of the fact na vice president yung father ko. Diba, a lot of people nga doesn't know how I look like. Kasi nga, I really value my privacy. So, nung pumasok yung pangalan ko sa survey and I was doing well, yung first meeting ng una, nandun yung name ko as a potential candidate, diba? My dad said, dun sa first meeting, tanggalin niya na yan kasi hindi yan tatakbo.
Okay.
Tapos, and true enough, ayun na, diba? Na,
okay, true enough.
Yun na yung request ng father ko. So, up to the last minute naman, kompleto yung slate namin eh. It also came to a point kasi pataas pa rin ako ng pataas dun sa mga survey. It came to a point na I said, please, tanggalin niyo na yung name ko because, I'm not running, and then yung mga supporters namin, na-excite kasi sila, na parang in spite of the fact na I'm not doing anything, I'm doing well din sa survey, di ba? So, last minute, nag-back out si Joey, si Congressman Toby Chanko yung binigyan nagsabi ng authority to decide kung sino yung kapalit.
Si Toby nag-decide na ikaw?
Si Kong Toby nag-decide. So, actually, third choice pa ako eh.
Who was all
that? I don't know. Pero alam ko, I'm the third choice. I think si Mayor Sherwin.
Okay.
Pero he declined. So, alam ko, third choice pa ako dun sa replacement kay...
So, you believe
because
it's...
Because they know talaga na ayoko, ayaw din ng daddy ko.
But you believe it's destiny for you?
I think so. Kasi, you know, sabi ko nga, I tried running away from this... calling, but at the end of the day, parang hahabulin ka din pala.
Oo. How did you handle the criticisms against you? I mean, I don't want to relive it, but even, you know, I mean, your color, diba, pati skin color mo, itsura mo. I mean, people were downright cruel.
Sabi ko, if you're coming from local politics, this is nothing new to me. Sana yung pamilya ko dyan, binabatikos kami tuwing election. Kaso lang, I thought, during this election, just this 2013 election, coming, iba na yung pamamalakad ngayon, di ba? So, akala ko, iba na rin yung uri ng pagka-campaign, pero apparently, it's more vicious and more, parang meaner nga yung nangyari sa akin. Diba?
What was the most hurtful criticism about you? Yung totoo? Naiyak ka ba at any point?
Hindi, kasi nga, hindi ko pinayagan na it will affect me eh. Parang pag may nabasa ako, tapos na. Yeah, masakit. And then, I have to move on or else, madederail ako dun sa pagka-campaign ko if I just, di ba, get bothered about it. Because at some point, pag nabasa mo, you get insecure, di ba? But hindi pwede mangyari sa akin yun. Kasi,
so, what was the most hurtful criticism?
Hurtful? Alam mo, hindi ko na matandaan, Karen. Kasi nga, hindi ako marunong magtanim eh.
Hindi ka nandidibdib?
Hindi ako nandidibdib.
Oo, hindi ka ganun. Hindi.
Ang pinaka nagkaroon lang ako ng concern was when they started including my children dun sa isang TPO. Isang parody na sinama nila yung anak ko.
Ah, parang meron na ganun. Did they make fun of your children, if you don't mind?
Parang yung nag-debate daw kami ng son ko or whatever. Parang may ganung ano.
Oo. Pero paano yun? You said you had feelings of insecurity. Can you
I mean, if I allow those things, magkakaroon ako ng feelings of insecurity, di ba? So, no. I didn't let that, ano.
Are you preparing for the Senate? I mean, Governor Vilma Santos, she actually enrolled in a course.
Yes, sabi ko nga, I'm going back to my alma mater.
You will?
I will take up yung mga short courses sa UPNC PAG.
Oo. At talaga, anong course?
They have this, customized for mga legislators. So, I'll attend, I think it's a 2 or 3 weeks class.
Oh, that's very interesting. Okay, so when are you enrolling? That's good to shoot, ha? You will be
muna,
studying,
I promise
ha?
My kids, magbabakasyon muna kami when I come back. I will go back to school.
Uh-oh. So that's number one. You will take short courses. So yes, you want to be prepared.
Of course. And then plus, I already talked to Senator Jinggoy Estrada, pati din si Senator Lauren Legarda to give me tips. Kasi syempre, yung UPNC PAG, more technical, diba? At least with Senator Jinggoy and Senator Lauren, medyo actual eh. Yung pwedeng inputs nila sa akin.
Correct. Anong committee ang gusto mo?
Unang-una, women and children because yun nga yung advocacy ko, especially dun sa children's welfare.
Okay.
Second, siguro yung Committee on Tourism kasi that's what I studied naman in college. Mm-mm. And ang laki-laki ng potential ng tourism industry. Sabi ko nga, nakakahiya i-admit, but during the campaign, I was like a tourist in our own country na ang ganda-ganda ng ating bansa. Na parang sabi ko nga, you know, you go to Italy to look at their old churches, samantalang dito lang sa Pilipinas, sa Pangasinan lang, halos each town na naikot namin, ang gaganda ng mga simbahan.
Oh. What bill will you file? Have you thought of one? I'm sure this was asked sa you during the campaign trail.
I want more children, yung mga daycare and feeding centers.
Okay.
Especially in rural areas, and then government offices, and private establishments. I don't know kung dito sa Channel 2, there's a facility na parang daycare facility.
May daycare ba tayo? Hindi ko alam eh. But I think pwede. I mean, it's a big building. But so you want daycares, but
feeding centers.
Yes.
Second one is I want to expand pa yung immunization program of our the government.
So you want to support health.
Yeah, are you health anti- and education for kids.
I'm curious, are you anti-RH? Well, it is a law, but it's pending right now. But are you anti-RH or pro? You're anti. Yes. So you don't believe in the use of contraception?
Kasi ang hirap to promote something that I'm not using, di ba?
Okay.
I have spaced my kids, right? Without using artificial means.
But how do you do it in Makati? I mean, in Makati, ano ang average number of children for the very poor?
I think four pa din eh.
Four lang?
Four.
Wala kayo yung 12 anak?
Parang
hindi
na kasi urban na, di ba?
Oo.
Usually, pag working na yung both parents, para nagiging natural way of controlling how many kids you will have kasi busy na, di ba?
Okay, good questions here. Do you think the conditional cash transfer program is working?
I think I will call then for a review of the CCT program.
Okay, how come?
I don't know kung yung long-term wise kung nakakatulong talaga siya eh.
Mm-hmm.
I think it needs to be reviewed. Tapos dapat meron lang, it shouldn't be done forever, di ba?
May
time limit eh. Tapos dapat ngayon pa lang ina-assess na natin kung little by little are they improving themselves, yung mga beneficiary ng CCT.
Okay, now this is interesting too. Classroom shortage. The new school year is about to begin. What would you do to finally solve the classroom shortage?
I think budgeting. And that's one work of a senator, di ba? Yung pagbabudget ng funds for the national government. We need more funds for education eh. I think, if I remember right, sabi dapat 6%. Pero as of the moment ata, we're just allotting 2% of the budget for education.
So you're ready to study this budgeting, taxation?
Yes.
I mean, di ba? Would you be able to interpolate? I mean, kaya mo si Miriam maka-interpolate?
UP graduate naman ako, di ba?
Okay. So, go ahead.
So, I think, I just have to prepare.
Diba? Because alam mo naman dun, di ba? I mean, you've seen them.
Yes. You know, I've attended a few hearings with my father. Kasi, di ba, once in a while, nag-a-appear siya sa mga committee hearing as chairman of HADC. And I've seen how they work.
Di ba? Kanino ka takot? May senador bang takot ka?
Siguro si Senator Miriam na ngayon yung medyo. Kasi si Senate President Enrile, nakasama ko na siya during the campaign.
Okay, are you ready that Senator Enrile might be replaced as the Senate President? You think that Team Pinoy has the numbers?
Well, that's a possible scenario. And you know, if that happens, I'm ready to be part of the minority.
Okay, alright. Disaster preparedness. Typhoon seasons. What do we do? Is there anything you feel that our country should do?
Una-una, yung mga nakatira dun sa danger zones, we should start removing them eh. Kaso lang may resistance on the ground.
Oo.
So,
paano sa Makati? Do you tolerate squatting?
So far, ang informal settlers sa Makati are dun na lang sa mga privately owned lands. Pero dun sa mga public, wala na sila.
Talagang natanggal na?
Yes. We already relocated them to Laguna.
Okay. How would you, palaging ang ehemplo nyo kasi, kung kaya sa Makati, dapat ganito rin ang buong Pilipinas. But how would you replicate Makati? I mean, let's face it, the business center, the Ayala Business Center is in Makati. You have, I think, 3 billion in real estate taxes or something. Basta, you have it in the bank in Makati. And that's why you have free schooling, yellow card, free hospitalization. How would you replicate that nationwide?
You know, it's just a proper spending of the people's money. Kasi nung when my dad took over noong 1986, bankrupt yung Makati. Kaso lang, I think, yung na-prioritize na yung dapat paggastusan. Kaya unti-unti naka-deliver siya ng mga services. But, you know, we came from a bankrupt local government. But, you know, look at Makati now, di ba?
Okay. I'm curious, have you read any of the corruption charges against your father? I mean, it's come out so many times on how much
sanay na kami
dyan.
Every election, merong anonymous letter. Sabi ko nga, if you're coming from local politics.
But is it true that pag may developer nagtatayo sa Makati, the Binays have to have one free unit?
No, it's not true. You know, if it's true, nakatira pa nga ako sa bahay ng father ko ngayon.
Until now. With your kids?
With my kids and with my other sisters na may kids na rin tsaka may asawa. So, you know, if that was true, di matagal na ako nag-move out, di ba?
Oo, nakatira ka na sa condo.
Pwede.
Okay, this is a good question from our one of our bosses here. What would you do with the Taiwan problem we have right now? I mean, we've apologized, okay? Remember, what do we do?
I think now we should start preparing for the eventuality na baka may mga kababayan tayo na bumalik dito from Taiwan, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
So, dapat meron ng measures how we can absorb yung workforce na madi-displace.
Do you think we should encourage OFWs in the long run? Hindi ba tayo hawak sa leeg palagi?
Parang nagiging, yun na nga yung nagiging concern eh. Yun na nga nagiging problema natin ngayon eh, di ba? In spite of the 6.6 economic growth. Pagdating naman din sa jobs, parang lumalaki pa yung percentage na jobless. Kasi in the first place, wala tayong investment sa manufacturing. Wala tayong investment sa agriculture. Yun yung number one industry na job creating. Kaso lang, we're all dun sa services eh. So I think we should start encouraging investments sa manufacturing, lalong-lalo na sa manufacturing and agriculture.
Okay, bilib ako dun ha. That's a very good point of view. Who's your mentor?
I'm always with my father, di ba? So,
okay.
Kasama yun dun sa, I'm always with him eh. So pag nagbe-briefing yung mga consultants niya.
Okay, all right. All right, we have photos for you. Can you describe it? And questions from Twitter and Facebook. All right, description, one word.
That's my father. My dad.
Oh, describe.
Daddy.
I mean, what's he like?
After this campaign, naging stage father.
Stage father? Okay.
Stage father.
Okay. So, are you close? You must be very close.
Yeah, because we stay in one house, diba?
Oh, oh.
So, every morning yan, I get tips from him. Lalo na during this campaign period.
Okay. I'm gonna ask you something. Your dad has to forgive me for this, but then again, it's politics.
Yes.
When he ran, there were photos of the other woman, and I think the other woman, I don't think it's another family, but another woman came out viral.
Yes.
It came out in the media, and I asked him about it.
Yes.
Tell me the truth. Did you resent or get mad at your dad that that had happened?
Actually, before it came out in the mainstream media, our local rivals were already showing that every night sa mga
campaign
rallies nila. So, nung lumabas siya sa national, ano, it was nothing new to us. Tsaka yung pangyayari na yon, it happened, I don't know, kung a few years back. We have all moved on. Yung mother ko has already forgiven him. Kumbaga, nagkaroon na ng forgiveness.
Oo. Okay, very interesting. Have you ever been asked this question?
No, first. Pero, you know, sabi ko nga, coming from the 2010 experience na, di ba, viral din yung attack against my father. So, I kinda expected na pagdating sa akin, medyo sa social media din yung attack eh.
Mm-mm. Okay, very good. Next. Okay. Oh, ito. This is your family. You have...
Yes, I have four, twins.
You have four?
Yes,
you have
four
kids. Okay. Okay. How do you feel when you see them?
Ano, blessed.
Blessed. Do you want any of them to enter politics?
As a mother, ayoko.
Okay, what does your husband do?
Their family is involved sa construction and real estate.
Okay, do they... real estate? Where? What's the name?
Ano sila? JV Angeles.
Okay, do they build anything in Makati?
No. Ano sila? They're into water.
Water?
Yes, mga dam, ganun.
I see. All right, next. Okay.
That's the dynasty.
Ano ba to? This is your family, no?
Yeah, that's my brother.
That's the dynasty. I can't. You're you know you're a dynasty. Do you admit?
Actually, kasi di ba when you say dynasty, birthright yun, di ba? Eh kami naman, we subject ourselves to an election, di ba? So, I think wrong word.
Oh, but clearly you know, you're taking it in stride. You're even making fun, kumbaga, of the term yourself.
Ay, kasi, you know, pagdidibdibin mo nga lahat, di ba, wala eh.
Oh,
sasakit lang ang loob mo, so...
Para mukhang matibay ka, ha? Okay. Alright, anonymous to, ha? Questions from our viewers. Anonymous, okay. If you were to declare your salen, how much are you worth?
I don't know.
You don't
Kasi
know?
I have to talk to my husband. Baka he's hiding something from me.
He's hiding from you.
Huh?
Okay, paano yan? Paano yan? Would your husband have to divest na?
I don't know kung ano yung extent ng pag-divest niya.
But is anything under your name, yung totoo? Ikaw, what's under Nancy Binay's name?
I think sa amin dalawa mag-asawa. We have a few properties.
Okay. Would you want to share what are those properties?
Well,
may Forbes dyan?
Wala.
Okay.
Wala.
Ano?
Well, right now, we're building a house right beside my parents.
Seriously?
Seriously.
Really? You're attached to your parents, huh?
Seriously.
You're an attached family.
Yes, we're close.
Yeah.
So we're building a house right beside their house.
Oh, okay. All right, Margo wants to know, how are you as a mother? Are you strict, diplomatic, or a perfectionist?
Balance, I think. Mm-hmm. You know, I can be strict and then I can be lenient at the same time.
All right. Anne asks, why didn't you run for Congress first and let your siblings with experience run for senator instead?
You know, I also asked the same question.
Did they want to run for the Senate?
Kasi my brother is just on his second term. Tapos my sister naman, last term na niya eh. So, di ba sayang naman kung hindi niya tatapusin yung term niya. Sabi ko din niya, weird part, somebody who's very reluctant to enter politics among the siblings. Ako pa yung naging national yung tinakbang. Sabi ko, you know, the offer to run, ang inano sa akin yung pagiging senator eh.
Do you consider yourself really lucky? I mean, you have Jack Enrile who's number 15, ha? Huh? I mean, and he was a congressman.
I guess, yun na nga, it's an appreciation of the service that my family can give.
Okay. All right. Who is your bet for Senate President?
Senate President Enrile.
Let's say if hindi na siya.
Senate President Enrile pa din.
Oo, yun pa rin.
Yes.
Okay. Your reaction that Mick Zubiri, I mean, they took him in, sacrificed Coco Pimentel, and Mick didn't make it. How do you feel that only three Una bets made it?
Sabi ko nga during my proclamation the other day, with a heavy heart, yung pag-attend ko dun sa proclamation because tatlo nga lang kaming nakapasok. And you know, what's nice with this campaign, talagang we became a family. Because we didn't have the same resources as Team Pinoy. So kami, we would take the commercial flights, we would take ferries. Ako nga, I never took a chopper to attend mga campaign sorties. So, ganun kami ka-close, you know. We would see each other in the airport 4 in the morning kasi yun lang yung flight na available. Mm-hmm. Talaga naging close kami.
And now, describe President Aquino. Because your father and him, I mean, I don't know if they are close or used to be close. I don't know the current standing.
Hindi, pero you know what's good with the parang Binay Aquino family relationship? Para kasi sa akin, it goes beyond politics eh.
Who are you close to? Are you close to Chris?
Yeah, I get to talk to Chris, pero more I think kay Balzi.
Really? Okay. So you've been close na for a
siguro kasi pareho kaming ate, di ba?
Uh-oh.
And during my mom's time as a mayor, like we would see each other. Siya kasama niya yung si President Cory, tapos ako naman kasama ko yung mother ko.
Okay. All right. Oh, sige, we have another hot copy. Sayang, you have to be back on Head Start, ha?
Sige.
Okay, last words.
Una, I would like to thank everybody for yung support tsaka yung tiwala na binigay nila sa akin. In spite of all the negative things that was said about me, kahit papano, I still got 16 million votes. So, thank you very much.
Okay, galit ka ba kay Vice Ganda?
Hindi. Sabi ko nga, I would like to congratulate him,
Vice, okay.
Vice Ganda, kasi nga, successful daw yung concert niya last Saturday.
Oh, so wala kang sama ng loob?
Wala.
Oh, tinanong ni Anthony.
Yeah, I have to respect yung his opinion, di ba, if he feels that way. I mean, what can I do?
Oh, now, tinanong ni Katunying, magpapagluta tayo ng shots ka ba?
Hindi. I love my color. Actually, if you notice, medyo ito lighter than the ano.
Yeah.
So ang balak ko, ipapantay ko na lang ito with this one para blacker na talaga.
All right. What would you want people to remember as you enter the Senate? Or your performance, how would you want, you must feel some pressure.
I guess siguro ako yung Binay na ano, talaga nagsilbi sa Senado because my family has already made their mark sa in terms of local governance and then my father naman sa executive branch. So I think ako naman dun sa Senate.
Okay, all right. Binay, congratulations.
Thank you.
Senator-elect Nancy
thank
Binay.
You.
Up next, I think babantayan ka ng tao. Ha? I think you're one person na babantayan.
Actually, sabi ko nga, I know yung detractors ko. This is just the beginning of negative things said about me. Kumbaga, it doesn't end with 2013.
2016 pa.
May 2016
pa. Vice Presidente, gusto mo tumakbo?
No.
All right.